Hello everyone, thanks again for stopping by my channel. If you are new here, my name is Emmanuel and I sell used computers and other accessories on eBay. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can upgrade the hard drive as well as the RAM on a HP EliteDesk 705 small form factor PC. I'm going to be showing you also how you can install a wireless LAN card onto this model of PC. If this is the kind of content you like, kindly consider smashing the like button and consider subscribing to my channel. Having said that, we're going to go into the video. The video itself was shot a few days ago. Why this PC sold on eBay is self-explanatory, and at every given point where I feel is necessary, I'm going to pause the video and chip in a point or two that I believe might be helpful to someone out there. And that's the wireless LAN card. I can really say that this is a very good product. I've used it for over 2 years without absolutely no problems. I'm gonna leave a link in the description below. It's an affiliate link where you can possibly get one if you want to. So it's important to note that these screws are actually two types. We have the black ones and we have the silver one. The black one would definitely fit into any 2.5 inches hard drive, while the silver one is mainly for the 3.5 inches hard drive. So in the video, we're going to be installing a 500 gigabyte hard drive and a 256 gigabyte SSD. That's the black screw being screwed onto the SSD, because the silver one would definitely be too big, it won't go in. Don't try to force it on or you're gonna destroy the SSD. So it's pretty much a typical HP EliteDesk build. Below the HDD the hard drive compartment is the small compartment for the SSD, and on the top is the wider compartment that fits the 3.5 inches hard drive. That's exactly how it looks when it's properly fixed. So this is actually easier to fix. You only need to push it in and slide it back a little bit, and thereafter you can plug in the SATA cable. That's a 500 gigabyte Seagate Barracuda hard drive. It's been erased. Everything is actually reset to formatted, so customer has no issues dealing with old files or whatsoever. Later on, I actually did a little bit of cable management, but for this video, I'm just going to leave it like this. Make sure everything is properly plugged in so that you don't experience an issue that has to do with hard drive not seen or something like that. It's a little bit tight there, but with a little bit of care, you should be able to get your hands into it and push in the SATA cables. But first attempt may be a little bit difficult, but because of the angle, but it should be fine. Ensure that the cables are properly plugged in, like I said. So that was it with the hard drives. Pretty fast there, I must say. for the wireless LAN card, we're going to take out the low profile bracket behind the PC. You want to break it if you want to, but it's not really necessary. But the thing is, we're going to take it out. So the wireless LAN card normally come installed with the full profile bracket. We're going to take that out, but if you were installing a tower PC, then this is fine. But as it is, this is a small form factor PC. We definitely have to take out the full profile bracket so that it fits into this PC casing. Otherwise it wouldn't fit and you may run into problems. And this is exactly why I like this model of wireless LAN card. It's come with two possibilities for you. If you have a tower PC or a small form factor PC, this card definitely fits. They are just two screws. It's pretty much easy to fix in. Screw them with a little few turns, it should be fine. And then you're going to take the wireless LAN card and push it into the PCIe slot of the PC. Ensure that you hear a little bit. It shouldn't clip, I believe, but make sure it's properly sitting so that you don't have connectivity problems later on. Just a little push. Yes, that should be fine. And that's how it looks when it's properly sitting. If you observe, I've not connected the antennas behind, because from my experience, each time I ship this PC with the antennas already installed, more often than not I experience problems. Either the antenna is broken, or so I just deliberately left it on the packet. I'm going to send the packet as well to the customer. The customer should actually find it very easy to install this when he or she receives the packet. So the RAMs are 4 GB each, DDR3, and you just need to slot them into the RAM slots of the PC. On this particular model, we've got 4 RAM slots, and pushing it in should be easy. And that's it. The PC is ready to be installed. All you have to do now is to cover the PC. The PC was installed with a Windows 10 professional operating system, and it was pretty much an easy ride. On a separate video, I actually took you through how you can install Windows on a PC like this, but it's standard process. So that was it. Thanks for watching, guys. Until I see you again, it's peace.